research on the community now. And then we're actually not going to do past the piece as part of the service today. We'll get up when we're saying goodbye to Judy and to Sam and Betsy and just, you know, do our greeting then. I think it makes more sense. We're hoping that Judy's coming as well. Sam and Betsy are here. We also have two fabulous guest musicians helping us create jazz worship today. So Heather Pearson and David Fox are both here with us. And so we thank you for your presence and your leadership. And this whole worship service is something of an improvisation, which goes with the theme of the jazz. So we will go with the flow. And afterwards, please do know that we're having a community barbecue. And there's hamburgers and hot dogs, there's vegetarian sausages, and or vegetarian burgers. There's a little bit for everybody, I hope. So please stay and eat, because we have a lot of food. And with that, are there any announcements for the life of the church or the community? Yeah. Jackson Community Church, whether you are new here, first timers, or very familiar faces, we are glad to have you here. My name is Reverend Gail, Doktor, and this is our first ever, I think, jazz worship service. Please join me in the call to worship, which is taken from a meditation by Frederick Buechner, and it talks a little bit about the connection between music and God's love. Doing the work you're best at, and that you'd like to do best. Hearing great music, having great fun, seeing something very beautiful. All these experiences are related to the experience of salvation. A closer analogy is the experience of love. When you love somebody, it is no longer yourself who is the center of your own universe. The one that you love is that center. So that by all the rules of arithmetic, there should be less of yourself than there was to start with. Only by a curious paradox, there's more. You give up your old self-seeking self for somebody you love, and thereby become yourself at last. To love is to be saved. It is a gift. We love because God's self first loved us. Some moment happens that we say yes to, right up to the roots of your hair. It is an experience that is trying to open up your whole life. This is the time during the service when we invite prayers of concern, of celebration, whatever you might wish to say out loud. We also create a moment of silence for anything that you cannot say out loud, but that you wish to hold in prayer and meditation with us. We usually begin with any prayer requests that came from the 8 o'clock gathering at the gazebo. This morning, the prayer request that we received was for a 16-year-old woman named Rita, who is currently sailing across, I believe, the Atlantic for the cause of environmental sustainability. She'll be speaking at the UN after she arrives, and she chose to sail because the fuel from an airplane is detrimental to the environment. So she chose a more sustainable way to even arrive from one continent to another. And so people were finding a lot of hope in her journey and in her message and the fact that our young people are using their voices and their special gifts to draw attention to things that they care so much about. So we pray for Greta's journey and for her message, that those who have ears might hear, and that wisdom will go where it needs to go. Are there other prayers for the life of our village, our valley, or the world? Sue.
Let's keep our tongue sealed in your thoughts and prayers as she begins another session with chemotherapy tomorrow.
Prayers for Seal and her ongoing treatment.
But she's doing well.
And for her resilience. She was out playing pickleball the other day, right?
Yes.
Right. Living with cancer and playing pickleball.
Is there a special time you want to recognize people that are...
Yes, there is. There's part of the service today that is actually saying goodbye to two families that are moving away. And so we will definitely create that. But a prayer for those who are going on journeys, who are going to the next parts of their life, for the uncertainty that that can bring with it, and the discombobulation, and yet the opportunities. May there be an opening of the way. And part of our conversation about jazz today is a conversation about journeys that we are taking. Any prayers? We pray always for Chicago Church, the Chicago Church in the city of Mutare, in the nation of Zimbabwe. Many of the churches here in New Hampshire have partner churches, and ours is the Chicago Church. And as we say, almost every week, this nation, like many others, is very hard-pressed economically. And a lot of it comes from unsustainable governance that is exploiting the country in partnership with corporations. So we pray for the people that need the dignity and wholeness of their lives to be restored, that they will find a peaceful way to do this. Other prayers. We also like to include in our prayers of thanksgiving for interesting things that you may have seen or experienced this week. Chris and I were just told by our neighbor that four bears walked in front of his door camera, and he's only one door down from us. So we know that there were bears in our neighborhood 2 days ago. I'm sure there are other people with bear stories. So does anybody have anything that has filled them up with joy that they'd like to share this week? Do you have something good to share? Because everybody's being awfully quiet. All right, there's one. So a doe and two fawns just this morning. So I see a hand over here. Lori, thank you.
I saw a lovely rainbow hair perched on the rock down in the pond right before Storyland on the left. It was just really, really nice.
Awesome. So, great blue hair. Ah, yes, thank you. All right, so overdue pregnant goats at Beach Hill Farm in Concord. That's a pretty big belly, isn't that? Some of the women in this congregation can relate. Any other prayers? Please join me then in prayer. O source and God of music, Christ, creator and comforter, the wellspring of love, and energy and resilience, we ask for a healing presence where it is needed, a guiding spirit where it is needed for Rita and other young people who are finding their way to speak out and make choices and shine a light on this world in a new way so that we may all pay attention. For those who are feeling disconnected or alone, for a sense of companionship and connection and community. For every person living with a change in body, mind, or spirit, whether it's mental health or addiction or some kind of diagnosis, and for the journey that these situations take us on, which in the end is simply part of being human and being our children, and for the great creation in which we all live, may you remind us to treat this world tenderly and respectfully, and know that we are handing down this place we live to new generations. May we do our best by them. Please hear us in our silence. And please hear us as we pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory forever. Amen. So before we go into the jazz portion of our service, now is the time to offer maybe just a little bit of a goodbye to Sam and Betsy and to Judy. And I think this is difficult for all of us, but I've heard that this is a tradition, so we're going to try it. So first, if you have something that you want to say out loud to Judy or Sam and Betsy, feel free to share it. I don't know if anybody's sort of worked up the courage to do this in person. Sam.
All of the support that she's given musically and spiritually. We've been through lots and lots and lots together, and there's been so much joy. There's been a part of it, so much care. And so I just want to recognize you and thank you for all that. And I will more to say that.
I just want to echo that. To the Hardys, what they have done, and Sam especially for his leadership when he was a kid. It is not an easy job, believe me, and one I've never thought I'd do before. The singing was absolutely marvelous, and I thank Alan also, and all of the congregation who joined us in, and has been so supportive of the music program in the church. It is truly wonderful, and I will take that with me wherever I go. Whatever church I end up in, my former one, which is Presbyterian, or the one across the street, which is United Church of Christ, I may split myself. which choir was doing it this morning? Anyway, I can't thank all of you for your, you know, for your attendance and for your support of the music. Truly appreciate it. And as I said, to Sam and Betsy and the rest of you.
I'd like to thank Sam because Sam is the one that gave me the opportunity to be part of this music program, and Jim has been very helpful as well, part of the choir. And I'm going to miss you. I wish you would ask to miss you both as you want to for your dedication. I hope you do come back with us.
This is for Toby's interview. Is there anybody else who wants to venture words right now, or are you saving them all for the barbecue?
Well, the choir and the community are diminished when these folks move on to their next stage in life. And I just want to say it's been great being associated with them. In particular, I wonder who's going to lead the next noble cause for us. And I know that when you go, it'll be well organized.
You guys first, and then Tim, go ahead.
Yeah, well, it is my turn. I want to say goodbye to you guys, but not goodbye. When I go and far away, our roots grow deep in the soil of this wonderful town. I look at each one of you, and I have another warm memory of something that something that we succeeded at, something that was frustrating us, changes that we brought through, practice that we had together. So, what I want to say is our bodies are going to be a little far away from here because we think that this is what we have to do, but we will always be in our hearts, truly, for all kinds of different reasons. And we're not going to be those who take off and go to Cumberland and don't come. We have really wonderful interests and friendships right here. This community, this church, has always been right at the embracing of us, challenging of us. And so that's really great. So I want to say hooray for the JCC and for all you people who are in it, who helped us to try to be what we've been trying to do. Maybe I should sit down.
That's easy for you. Have a feeling of this thing.
I'm just saying that when my wife Claire and I came here a year ago, we had come from a different environment, a different denomination. So we weren't really more sure how comfortable we would be here. And Bessie, Sam, and Judy were some of the first people we met and talked to. And they really made us feel very comfortable. Like this would be a good fit for us, and it has been. So I want to thank them for that.
Lori, I just wanted to say thank you to both Sam and Bessie for just a much larger picture of all the good work and strong beliefs they had throughout the years. And I think it all really came to a head for me one day. I was listening to the radio, and I don't know. Sunday night, it's out in Philadelphia, and they always spotlight people who have done good things. And the next thing I know, they're talking about the Harveys on the radio. And they had been recognized for all their work in Russia. And I just thought, I am so proud to know these people. And that is just one small thing that they have done and instilled in our whole community. So, how did I ever become so lucky to end up being their neighbors? How about them? I don't know, but I love them very much for that and just all the work that they've done. I certainly will miss them. I know we have strong connections throughout our families as well. So thank you. You will be missed.
Anybody else have any messages for Judy or Sam or Betsy? Then I would ask the three of you to come forward so that we could actually lay our hands on them and we will say a blessing together. Do you guys mind coming forward and Judy, would you come forward? And then Irene, you're the deacons, and Tom, you're the deacon. All my deacons come forward and you'll sort of create the human chain to connect people out to the pews. So I need one or two people over on this side. Heather and Davey, you guys want to be part of the chain. This is just sort of like a love. This is touching. You're just touching here. Mary, why don't you come forward, Alan? And then we all just sort of want to hold hands so that basically, one way or another, you actually have to kind of maneuver yourself a little bit here. Touch your shoulder if that's what needs to happen. That's okay too. One way or another, everybody's sort of part of this connection, right? Okay. So you will find this blessing in the bulletin, but I'm just going to read it out loud, and I ask that you all be in a moment in a space of giving your love and your hope and your presence to Betsy and Sam and Judy, as we call upon the Spirit of God to help them on this journey. With every step you take, this blessing rises up to meet you. It has been waiting long ages for you. Look close and you can see the layers of it, how it has been fashioned by those who walked this road before you, how it has been created of nothing but their determination and their dreaming, how it has taken its form from an ancient cloak that drew them forward and made a way for them when no one could be seen. Look closer and you will see this blessing is not finished, that you are part of the path it is preparing, that you are how this blessing means to be a voice within the wilderness and a welcome for the way. May a love that makes a way, that moves through the world, move in your lives as you have moved in ours, and see the blessing of this community, which sends you with all of its hope and its love out into the world, to wherever you go next. May you feel us with you, and know that you are knitted and woven deeply into our stories, and the door is always open for you. Go in peace, and go in blessing. May you all see this. A series of songs and scripture.
What I see and hear,
I did not come into this world to be comforted. I come, like Redbird, to sing, but I'm not Redbird. With his head mop of flame, and the red triangle of his mouth, full of tongue and whistle. But a woman whose love has vanished, who thinks now too much of roots, and the dark places where everything is simply holding on. But this is too, I believe, is the place where God is keeping watch, until we rise and step forth again and, but wait, be still, listen. Is it that bird? Or something inside myself, sing.
The first reading comes from Book 2, Chronicles, Chapter 5, Verse 13. The song was raised with trumpets and cymbals and other musical instruments in praise to the Lord. For God is good, for God's steadfast love endures forever. The house of the Lord, is filled with the cloud. The second reading is from Psalms chapter 40, verse 3. Put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God.
So as I said, everything today is improv, so you'll find that there's an insert in your bulletins, and I have some of the selections of scripture with text about music in it, and we've invited Irene to choose the ones that speak to her this morning and read those out when we're reading scripture, but we hope that in the bulletin you will find something that speaks to you this morning.
This is a song that was written by Irving Berlin.
I'm still alone with a tale.
Psalm 108, verse 1. My heart is steadfast, O God, my heart is steadfast. I will sing and make melody, awake my soul. The second one is from Isaiah chapter 55, verse 12. For you shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands.
Please pray with me. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. I'll keep my comments brief because we really want to enjoy the music. However, it's important to note that there's a very strong connection between music and faith. That the Bible itself is full of whole books that are song books. 150 songs are written in the Psalms alone. Then there's the Book of Lamentations and the great book, the Song of Solomon. Women's voices were preserved in songs in the Bible, though they were redacted out of much of the Bible. They were preserved. The Magnificat that Mary sings at the birth of Christ is the voice of a woman singing out to God. And throughout the Bible, the songs were sung for different reasons. They were sung, the first song that's recorded in the order in which we read the Bible is the song of Moses after they've been saved and there has been victory. And the very final book, Revelations, and the song that it has at the end of its book is a resumption of the song of Moses yet again. And the shortest song in the entire Bible talks about the enduring and the steadfast love of God. And there's just a few small references in the Gospel to the fact that Christ sang songs with his followers, especially after the Last Supper. Song is embedded in our tradition. Sometimes we get all the lyrics, and sometimes we get a one-line reference to the fact that people were singing and dancing. And they did it for every reason imaginable. They did it out of joy, to shout out praise, to express gratitude, to cry out to God in sorrow and anger and confusion. Any emotion that you can imagine sharing with your God is written into the Bible someplace, and often it is sung out loud. And how fitting that this tradition then becomes the tradition of resilience and resistance for people that are oppressed. Jazz grows out of multiple traditions. It grows out of the tradition of the African American spiritual, which is sung in a time of oppression and slavery. And though the people that were enslaved adopted the religion of those that were oppressing them, they found their own way to use those same texts to find hope for themselves. Jazz also grows out of things like ragtime and marching bands and the blues. And the theology that you can find when you listen for it in jazz is one that moves from the deepest lamentation and sorrow and crying out to a place of hope. One scholar named William Edgar, talking about the combination of jazz and Christianity, says that the theology of the blues and the theology of the spiritual is this, that God will be with us through our suffering, that there will surely be mountains ahead of us. And the people that were singing these songs to give themselves hope and resilience, didn't have the obstacles moved away for them magically when they sang and they prayed. Slavery didn't end overnight, and even when slavery was lifted away, oppression is still happening and still continues to happen. So the theology and the promises of the music was not that all the troubles and the suffering would be swept away, but God would be present in the midst of the suffering. And what was needed to get up and over the mountain, the strength and the resilience to go up the mountain and stand at the top of the mountain, and the grace to go through the obstacles and the challenges that face us is with us always. Music is inherent in our culture from the time humanity was born. When you scan a human's brain, every part of the brain lights up when people are listening to music. And as you've heard me say before, the power of that music lasts in our minds. When somebody is living with dementia or Alzheimer's and you play the playlist of their lives, even people who have been unable to speak, who can no longer express emotion or may not be able to access their memories, will have parts of their brain reconnected by the power of music. People that have been silent for 2 years can lift up their head and express emotions and speak to those that they love, though they have been locked inside their mind and disconnected for so long. The power of music is not a story or a fairy tale. It is science. It is inside our flesh and our bones and our hearts and our minds. And we call on it again and again for the resilience and the healing and the hope that we need in the world, even when the worst things are happening to us. Almost any one of us can name a song that has made a difference, and that if we hear it now, may move us to tears, to an unspeakable place while we hear what that music says to us. So imagine an entire genre of music that helped an entire people survive slavery and oppression and continues to seep into the new music traditions of today and inform those traditions and continues to give that same hope and resilience. And it is rooted in that same promise. It is the promise of love that walks in the world, that lives in each one of us, and it is steadfast. It is enduring. It is unstoppable. And though there's only one line in the Gospels that says that Christ sang a song with those that he loved, and we don't know what the words were, recall that he pulled from an entire scripture, an entire book full of songs, and they were all there for him. Whether it was sorrow or joy, he had the songs he needed to sing with the people that he loved. And those songs are our songs. And jazz is our national music. And it is the voice of our people, all of our people, reaching out beyond sorrow to hope, believing that the strength and the resilience that we need is there for us, and that grace and love will see us through. And it doesn't promise to be easy, this road that we walk. But we don't do it alone, and we do it with hope and belief that love is meeting us and walking with us. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
So would my deacons come forward as we prepare to collect our offering? And just a reminder, this church remains a safety net. It remains a safety net for our partners in other countries, whether it is through the work that we do when Meg goes to Honduras, or the hope that we send to Zimbabwe. And we are also a source of hope and healing here in this valley. We ask that you will give as you are able, knowing that the love that you give here goes back down into the world, just like the music. Those are the words of Duke Ellington come Sunday morning. Please come. Please rise for that fellowship. please, Lord, look down and see our people free. Bless these offerings that we have given, and bless our lives.
Amen.
We're going to go right into the benediction, and then we're going to have a host booth that is jazz music by Heather and Dave. Inspire you and heal you and guide you. Go in peace.